by far, the sharpest dressed man here. I mean, look at this. This is styling and profiling, looking only as you should look. Josh Niblett from Gainesville. Man, how much thought went into piecing this together?
Well, I've had this since I got to Gainesville. So when I got there, I wanted a red suit. And so, you know, we had it made, and actually we bought a bunch of blazers for the players to take pictures in also. And so, you know, I had pants with it and this. I went and got them altered and tailored and all that. So, hey, any opportunity. This is the third time I wore it this week, though. So, you know, anytime I'm representing the Red Elephants, I'm going to put the red suit on, though. So I'm proud of it. Thank you.
Let me ask you, looking back to last year, obviously you make it to the last game of the year, but you don't win the last game of the year. Yeah. The lessons that you take from 22 that you bring to 23, what are they?
Well, I think the biggest thing is find that 1%. You know, we got to find that 1% to finish. You know, if I put my index finger and my thumb apart an inch, most people last year would say, hey, you were that close. But in our building, we see it as that far away. So whether you see that glass is half full, half empty, you know, it's not there yet. And so we got to find the 1%. As a head coach, I got to figure out what is that 1%. Is it in a practice schedule? Is it something we got to do off the field? Is it mindset training? And then our players have got to figure it out. You know, I mean, that's the other thing. So really on top of everything that we did last year, now it's a search for that 1% on top of that individually. So collectively, we'll have it as a team.
So how has that 1% search gone in the spring and summer?
It's been awesome. I mean, I'm just proud of our kids. I'm proud of our players. Proud of our senior class. This is a special senior class now, not but just because they're very talented, but there's a lot of leadership and there's a lot of accountability being held, a lot of shared experiences where they want to spend time with each other. That's why I brought our senior class. We leave here, we're going to take them out to eat and, you know, spend some time with them because, you know, my son's in this class. But I knew this class would have a chance to be special because of the class they got to follow last year that left a legacy behind at Gainesville.
So since you mentioned those senior leaders, we like to talk recruiting. I know a lot of folks like to do that. Who's going where? Who's declared? Who's getting looks? And is there anybody on that level below that might not be getting a look or a look they deserve because they're too whatever?
Well, we got a few of those, you know. But, you know, like, you know, Zion Ferguson's going, you know, to North Carolina. And then, you know, you got Champ Thompson's going to Clemson. Nick Taylor's going to Appalachian State. You know, and then we've got some other guys that are going to have some opportunity, like Travion Watson, you know. Baxter's going to have some opportunities. But I think guys like, you know, Eric Hart, Marcel Hensfield, two receivers we got that are special. You know, Sky Niblett, my son. I mean, I think he's a heck of a player, not because he's my son, but, you know, if Sky was 6'4", he'd probably have every offer. But, you know, he's 6 foot and he's a tight end. So, you know, you feel like some of those guys don't get looked at because of some of their measurables. And I think we've got some other guys that are going to have some opportunities to go play at the next level. You know, Noe Cavarubias is our center, very smart kid, excellent player. Gavin Hall is a kid that, you know, we're excited about for him. I mean, he's going to go and play ball at Furman. So, you know, we got a good group of guys coming back, and we got a group of guys that we got to make sure we get them a spot to go play ball.
How special is this to share this with Sky?
It is. It's just me and his mama talked about it the other day. It's kind of surreal, but it's like a double-edged sword. You know, it's bittersweet. You know, I coached my oldest boy who's 24 now, going to his sixth year of college. And, you know, when that was over, I knew I had Sky, so it was a little bit different. And now knowing that this is the last time, I just want every savor, every moment, every practice, every lift, every moment I get to spend with him.
When you look at your schedule, the first 10, because I know you want to get to 15, when you look at your first 10 on the schedule, what do you see this year?
I think the biggest thing that I see is, for us from a perspective, I've got to focus on what we're doing. You know, last year we had to prove everybody wrong. Now this year we got to prove everybody right. And so when you look coming out of the gate against Marist, I mean, heck, we're playing Milton in the scrimmage. So we're coming out of the gate. We're going to find out what we're made out of. I think our region, I mean, there's going to be some opportunities there. We got to make sure we show up every week ready to play. We got Mountain View. We got Coconut Creek out of Miami, Florida coming in. So when you're looking at it, we just got to focus game in and game out about being 1-0. I know everybody says that, but for us, that's kind of what we talk about on a day-to-day basis. Let's just lock in on the moment and take them as they come.
What's it been like for you to embrace what football means to Gainesville? It's more than just this. What's it been like for you to embrace what it means?
But that's why I'm in this, all right, because I'm proud of the standard we have there and the tradition that we have there. We want to continue to add to that. We'll never do anything to take anything away from it, but we want to add value to it. I felt like last year we brought a lot of pride back. You know, we brought a lot of that oneness back into the community. I mean, it was standing room only every game. I expect the same thing this year, but I'm visible. I want to be around people. I want people to know about Gainesville football within our city limits and get them to want to enjoy the experience to be a part of it. I mean, we're a third-generation program. I mean, we got people that come to games that played in the 70s, 60s, and then we got kids that play for us now that their dads played or cousins or uncles. And so it means a lot to a lot of people because it's a tight-knit family and it's a tight-knit community.
Last question, and this is the Hannah question. Hannah has a question that she asks all the coaches that here in the preseason.
Yep.
Do you, sir, have a ritual, or is it to the point of a superstition when it comes to football Fridays, or would you like to share with the class a funny coaching story about your time as a coach?
Wow. Wow, I don't know. I'm going to let you tell me which one you want. So,
let's go superstition. I know coaches are superstitious or ritualistic, depending on if they say, I'm not superstitious, I have rituals. You tell me.
So, I don't know if they're superstition, they're just routine.
Yeah.
All right, so I've got to have my Panera coffee. I'm in the Unlimited Sip Club, so I got to have my Panera coffee on Friday mornings. We have team breakfast. I make sure I have that with me, so I got an extra coffee in the morning for the walkthrough after it. You know, when I get my stuff for the game, I put it in a rolling suitcase. So I take a rolling suitcase to the game. I think that's stuff everybody kind of looks for. And then my ritual, I don't ever wear the same thing in warm-ups I'm going to wear during the game. And so that's a little something that I do also. And I'm going to have a spark made by Advocare before the game. And so, you know, I'm a high-energy guy. And, you know, yeah, well, yeah. But I'm not about superstitions, but I am about routine.
There we go. That's Josh. That's Gainesville here in 23.